Hi friends, welcome to WSOT with a cup of coffee. This is Prabhakar and Toritot Simbian. Today we are going to start the identity server series, and in the first video of identity server series we are going to discuss about components, architecture and the features of identity server in detail. Let's get into the video.
What is an identity server? It helps us to manage the identities of the user, like attributes of the user, roles, permissions of the user, etc. And it allows us to secure the web applications and the API using OAuth mechanism or OpenID Connect, XAML, SSO, to name a few. This is the actual architecture of identity server. I know it might be a little overwhelming, but let us take this one part at a time and discuss in detail. So the identity server has the following components: service provider, identity provider, inbound authenticator, local authenticator, federated authenticator, authentication framework, and provisioning framework. Service providers provides a web service and it relies on the identities that are stored in the identity provider. Here, the identity server acts as the identity provider and takes care of the authentication and authorization of the user. Identity provider can be an external application where the user identities are stored. Here, some samples are like Facebook, Yahoo, Google. So with the identity or the credential which you have used in a Facebook, Yahoo, or Google, you will be able to sign into the application through this service provider. Now, coming to authentication framework. So authentication framework has three different types of authenticators. One is inbound authenticator, local authenticator, and federated or outbound authenticators. So inbound authenticator has request processor and response generator. The responsibility of inbound authenticator is to parse and validate the incoming authentication request and frame authentication response. And the local authenticators can be of two types, either username or password that are stored in identity server, or integrated Windows authentication that are stored in identity server. Next is federated authenticators. When you don't want to use the local authentication that are stored in identity server, you can opt for federated authentication, which means you are going to add an identity provider from one of these mentioned items. And for example, Facebook, Yahoo, or Google, and you can use the credentials that are provided for Facebook, Yahoo, or Google to log into your web application. So this is a federated authentication mechanism. As you can see, authentication framework has two subcomponents called in and out. These are the different types of provisioning. So the authentication framework talks to provisioning framework. So first let's talk about what is provisioning. Provisioning is storing the credential of the just authenticated user to an identity provider. So let's say there are three types of provisioning: inbound provisioning, outbound provisioning, and just-in-time provisioning. So inbound provisioning is provisioning the user into the identity server. Outbound provisioning is to provision the user to the external application like Facebook, Google, or Yahoo. Just-in-time provisioning is used when you use federated authentication. A classic example is that you go to a web application and instead of signing up, you use your Google credential to sign up to that application. So what just-in-time provisioning does is, like, when the credential you have passed in the Google login page is valid, it creates the same user into the identity server at the time of authentication. So that is called just-in-time provisioning. When your authentication is successful, it will immediately provision the user into the identity server. And there are different kinds of user store manager as well. So in the identity server, all the values that we have discussed about will be stored in some form in the user store. The user store can be of different types, like a classic JDBC, RDBMS user store, Active Directory, or LDAP based user store. So we have discussed enough in detail about identity server architecture. In the next video, we will see how to set up, configure, and run identity server in your local desktop or laptop.
Please do provide your valuable suggestions and feedback in the comment box, and also share this video with someone who will be interested to learn WSO2. Thanks everyone. Please take care of yourselves in this current COVID-19 pandemic situation. We will meet in the next videos or the upcoming videos. Until then, it's Prabhakar and Toritot Simbian signing off. Bye.